been a martial artist my whole life, around since age 3. I'm always pushing myself and always trying to be better at what I do, refining my craft. It's been a long process, and at this point I'm really excited to take that next step, win this fight, and go up for it and take that big step for the contract.
This fight does have big implications, If he beats me, he's going to Bellator. If I beat him, I'm getting the title, and I'm trying to get my foot in the door in Bellator. So, I mean, this is a big fight for sure. From what I know about Zach Lucia, he's a good striker. I used to throw a lot of kicks. He's got a lot of experience. He's fought a lot of tough dudes, and he's beat a lot of tough guys. He comes in, he's game to fight.
My opponent looks really tough. I've been checking out some of his videos and stuff like that. He's big, he's strong, he's athletic, and he seems pretty well-rounded. I think some of my advantages over him, first and foremost, would be my level of experience. I don't think he hasn't been there as much as I have. He hasn't been around as long as I have, and I think I'm going to be more technical than he is.
He's got experience on me. I can't say or do anything about that. It's going to change that. I just go out there and fight my fight. I fought tough guys, I fought more experienced guys than him before. I'm not even gonna think about that. I'm just gonna go out there and fight and adjust to whatever I need to in the fight. We match up pretty well. We're a little bit different styles as far as on the feet. I think I'm a little bit more of a boxer. He's a little more of a kickboxer on the ground. I think he's a little more of a jiu-jitsu guy, and I'm kind of more of a wrestler and a top guy. So I think it'll be a good clash of styles, and I think whoever is gonna be able to implement their game plan is gonna be the one who wins.
He'll be big, and he'll probably be a little bit bigger than me. But I've fought that before. I'm not afraid to put down giants, and never have been. I'm gonna get in there, set a pace that he can't handle, and start throwing it down, start picking him apart.
It is time for our main event of the evening. Aaron Highfield challenges Zach Buescia for the Shamrock FC welterweight title. As we go to our Robeck Realty Keys to Victory, Aaron Highfield has got to get inside, use his power in those hands, and avoid that very tough head kick of Zach Buescia. Zach Buescia needs to be technical. It's what he does in every fight. He has to control the distance, stay away from those heavy hands, and stay long to be able to land that big kick.
St. Louis, you asked for it, you got it. This is a Shamrock FC world title match. Are you ready? Let's bring him out, Aaron Highfield.
Making his way to the cage, it is Aaron Highfield. Aaron Highfield sporting a 5-2 record, coming off a huge knockout over Ty Flores. He's absolutely going insane coming to the cage right now.
Yeah, he's starting to go to the wrong corner. He doesn't care where he goes, he just wants in that cage.
Aaron Highfield has literally fought some of the toughest in this sport. His boxing background has afforded him power in both of his hands. Literally, he has one hitter quitter knockout in every shot that he takes.
Yeah, Highfield has a ton of power in both hands, but he's going against the Shamrock FC champ who has a ton of experience in this corner.
Aaron Highfield has got to get inside. He wants to use that power and avoid those head kicks. As we talked about earlier, Zach Buescia just absolutely laid those on UFC vet Bobby Volker in his last outing in Kansas City to win the title.
And Highfield needs to save some of that energy. He's very excited right now, but this is a 5-round fight. Aaron Highfield has never gone 5 rounds. We saw Zach Buescia look fresh as can be in the 5th round against Bobby Volker to win the Shamrock FC title belt.
Let's bring out the champion, Zach Buescia!
Coming to the cage, it is our champion, Zach Crash Buescia. He is absolutely on a tear as of late, coming by way of Lawrence Fight Club. Now let's go to our first form supplements tale of the tape. Aaron Highfield, 26 years old, 5'10", 169 pounds out of Bunker Hill, Illinois. Zach Fuchsia, 32 years old, 5'10", 168.8 pounds, out of Lawrence, Kansas. On the line tonight, not only is the Shamrock FC welterweight title, but this is Zach Fuchsia's defense. If he wins this, he will be offered a four-fight contract in Bellator MMA.
Yeah, and Zach Fuchsia wants that more than anything. You know, he is so happy being the Shamrock FC champion, but he wants to move on to Bellator. He thinks he can win a world title in Bellator.
He would be following on the likes of Becky Ruth, Justin Lawrence, and many others. But it's time for our main event. Let's send it up to the cage to Stephen Bayer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is our main event of the evening, and this is for the Shamrock Fighting Championship world title. Tonight, fighting out of the Metro PCS blue corner this evening, he stands 5 feet, 10 inches tall. He weighs in at 169 pounds, fighting out of Bunker Hill, Illinois, Aaron Highfield. His opponent tonight, the champion fighting out of the Metro PCS red corner this evening. He stands 5 feet, 10 inches tall. He weighs in at 168.8 pounds. Fighting out of Lawrence, Kansas, Zach Fuchsia.
Referee Mike Anglin has the call for our main event this evening. Aaron Highfield in the blue tape, Zach Crash Fuchsia in the red. These will be five-minute rounds in the Shamrock FC welterweight division. Quick touch of the gloves. Fuchsia always very elusive.
Very elusive and very calm in there. You put Fuchsia in a bad position, he doesn't freak out. He just works out of it.
Now, Fuchsia stays very relaxed, but he's got to watch those big hands of Highfield. Again, here comes that left high kick. We've always said Aaron Highfield could be the better wrestler. Fuchsia, though, a Brazilian jiu-jitsu brown belt.
Looking for a Kimura, Fuchsia. Let's go of it.
Nice take.
Looking for the Kimura again.
Fuchsia trying to lock up that Kimura. Highfield looking to pressure.
Yeah, Highfield's doing a good job of hiding his arm in between his legs.
Fuchsia still working that position.
If Fuchsia can get it out off behind the back.
Highfield trying to step through here, giving that shoulder a little bit of relief. Nice move there by Highfield. Fuchsia gives it up.
Fuchsia looking for a triangle.
Fuchsia going high, working that rubber guard position.
Excellent defense out of Aaron Highfield.
Highfield is smothering the champion here, trying to work those big hands.
As I said earlier, Zach Fuchsia is just going to relax. He's just going to work here. He doesn't freak out. Too experienced for that.
Fuchsia has a very active guard as well.
Exactly. He's always threatening, always being dangerous. Not going to let Highfield get comfortable sitting in his guard.
Highfield trying to fight those hands, looking to drop the body head in this position. Fuchsia looking at a potential sweep. Back to full guard.
Good top pressure out of Highfield, just maintaining this position.
Halfway through the first round of this five-round fight. Highfield again keeping that heavy pressure on Fuchsia.
You know, again, Heifel's not doing a ton of damage, but he's maintaining position and he's winning the round. all the rounds Highfield can put in the bank is the better for a five-round fight, which he's never done.
Also maintaining that top position, he gets to breathe a little bit as we are down to 2 minutes remaining in this first round. Buescher, though, trying to work that guard a little higher. Again, active from the bottom. Buescher putting the feet on, trying to make it. Aaron Heifel stepping over into half guard.
A lot of top pressure out of Heifel from this half guard position, trying to make Buescher uncomfortable.
Buescher trying to sit up on his hip here.
Buescher has the underhook on the left side. Look for him to get on his right hip and start to work out, work for a sweep.
Back to full guard is Buescher. Heifel working heavy hands from this position.
Looking for a triangle. Nice job by Heifel to pop the head up.
Heifel is just absolutely making this dirty as we are down to 1 minute remaining in the first round. Heavy hands coming out of Heifel. Zach trying to establish a guard here, trying to look for a potential sweep.
Buescher keeps going back looking for that triangle, defended perfectly by Aaron Heifel.
Heifel very high there, taking the back of Buescher.
Yep. That is close. I can't see if it's under the
neck. 20 seconds.
Nice elbows out of Heifel.
Again, looking for that rear naked choke right in front of us. 10 seconds remaining in the first round. Heifel very heavy on the champion. Big damage there in that first round coming out of Heifel. Very heavy top pressure.
Absolutely. Excellent top pressure. And the big thing is Heifel defended every submission attempt that Buescher threw up at him.
Heifel had the ability here to defend every submission so far that Buescher has thrown at him.
100%, he defended them all perfectly. Nothing was even close to being completed, and no submissions were close from Buescher, and he threw up a lot of them.
As we go to our Mattingly Lumber instant replay here, we look at the end of the fight. We see Aaron Heifel start to land some big elbows, then the hammer fist, trying to get that rear naked choke in. Time ran out though, nice work out of Buescher. Round two of this 5-round contest. Buescher trying to set the range here. Heifel swinging. Nice leg kick there coming out of the champ. Nice inside leg kick coming out of Heifel. Big going high is Heifel. Answers though with the nice hands. Huge head kick out of Heifel himself.
Yeah, Heifel looking to return the favor. Buescher keeps throwing head kicks at him. He wants to throw one right back.
Heifel looking to establish that jab.
You know, both fighters are very cautious not to overcommit on their punches and give up an easy takedown.
Heifel, though, just seems to be content to eat the body kick, bite down on the mouthpiece, and throw the counter. Again, Heifel going upstairs.
And again, something to remember, this is a 5-round fight. Both fighters are being very patient, not trying to make a mistake that's going to lose them around.
Heifel just missing with a big right hand. Heifel getting the better of these exchanges so far in the boxing area.
Oh, that one
woke him up.
Like I said earlier in the pre-interviews, Boucher can get that leg up quick.
Yeah, it's extremely fast coming in. Big body shot from Heifel. Halfway through the second round of this five-round title fight. Zach Boucher in the red trunks. Aaron Heifel in the black. Spinning back kick is Heifel.
This is halfway through. This is anybody's round.
Boucher seems to be still trying to find his range.
Yeah, I think that takedown in the first round for Heifel made Boucher a little weary to step in too much on his punches.
Again, good inside leg kick coming out of Heifel. Again, big head kick out of Heifel. Excuse me, out of Boucher. But Heifel lancering with those punches.
Round two has been a back and forth stand-up battle. Very technical out of both fighters.
Heifel doing a good job, though, keeping that right hand cocked at the head. Something Bobby Volker had to do as well, as we are down to 1 minute remaining in the second round.
And again, this whole round could come down to this last minute. If one of these guys can get a takedown, that would probably seal the round for them.
Heifel, big right hand.
45 seconds, St. Louis, come on, let's make some noise.
Again, just a snap there, big though. Left hook out of Heifel. Boucher trying to find his range still. Heifel going upstairs, mixing up the punches and the kicks. Nice knees out of both fighters. Heifel swarming. Eats a big knee though, trying to get the takedown to steal this round. Boucher trying to hold on. He defends the takedown well at the end. How do you see that?
I mean, that's a toss-up round. There's not much to choose from. Neither guy landed a ton of good stuff. They both landed decent, but nothing really to stand out. I think Heifel was a little bit busier. I can see a judge giving it to either fighter. I'm gonna give it to Heifel. I got him up 2-0.
As we go to our Mattingly Lumber instant replay, Heifel swarming here at the end, looking to get that finish, trying to get the takedown to steal the round. Boucher does a great job, though, of defending.
Yeah, but that swarm at the end there might have won him the round just on throwing that many punches at Boucher.
Third round of this fight. Touch of the gloves. Both fighters still look extremely fresh. Head kick coming out of Boucher. Outside leg kick from the champion answered with an inside leg kick from the challenger. Good combinations coming out of Heifel. Oh, big head kick.
Heifel just got his hand up in time.
again with the head kick. Highfield almost bent right into that one.
Boucher is always dangerous.
Spinning back kick out of Highfield. Eats one of his own. There is Boucher throwing the hands. Again with
another
the head,
head kick.
Kick.
Boucher gets that up there quick and easy.
Not only is Boucher a brown belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, he is a black belt in Kung Fu.
If Boucher would set that kick up with his hands a little bit, it might be a little easier to land.
Oh, takes the leg out. Highfield looking to pressure now. He's trying to bully our champion in the corner.
Boucher needs to do everything he can to get out of this position. He was doing a great job at distance, standing up with Highfield at the beginning of this third round.
Big takedown coming out of Highfield. This is not where the champion wants to be.
Oh, Highfield muscled that takedown, all power.
Scramble here from the champion, trying to get up. Traps the leg, gets the takedown of his own.
Beautiful
job. Move.
Again, experience. What I said at the beginning, Boucher is not going to panic ever. Let's see what Highfield can do from his back. He needs to get out of this side control position.
Almost in a crucifix position here. Highfield almost tried to bench press him off. Boucher, happy to stay here in the side control position, starts to work some elbows, stepping across into mount. Highfield with a nice reversal, but he's got to watch out for the triangle.
Excellent job by Highfield, the power out of that triangle.
The strength of Aaron Highfield coming through. Minute and 30 left here in the third round.
In a very close third round. Boucher needs to work to get up.
Again, Highfield has heavy pressure, keeping those forearms and the elbows in the face of Boucher. Down to 1 minute remaining here in the third round. Boucher looking for the armbar.
Highfield has done an excellent job of defending all the submission attempts thrown up by Boucher.
Aaron landing the heavy punches here. This is a great game plan out of the challengers. We are down to 30 seconds remaining in the third round of this five-round contest. Jeremy Johnson along with my partner Kevin Engel live in the main event for Shamrock FC 295.
Looking for the triangle again.
Again, Highfield scramble, starts landing some punches, takes the back of Boucher. 10 seconds remaining in this round. He's gonna give him a huge slam.
That took a lot of strength and energy, and Highfield has two more rounds to go.
As we move here into championship rounds, how do you see the fight so far?
I mean, I had Boucher winning that round until the very end there. You know, that last minute could definitely sway that round in the judges' eyes. It could either be 2-1 Highfield or 3-0 Highfield.
As we go to our Mattingly Lumber instant replay, Aaron Highfield muscles his way to a gigantic slam of Boucher, maintaining that top position.
Boucher could very well need a stoppage to win this fight.
This very well could be 3-0 at the moment.
Certainly could. Could be 2-1, but you know, you never know in the judge's eyes. If I'm in Bush's corner, I want him to keep working, try and get a stoppage in the fourth or fifth round, which Heifel has never been in before.
No, now we move to championship rounds here. Oh, we got a little spilled ice on the ground here. That's got to move that out. That's never safe. Referee Mike Anglin taking care of the spilled bag of ice. Moving to the fourth round, quick touch of the gloves. Both fighters still look good and fresh here coming into the championship rounds.
If I'm in the corner of Heifel, I want him to intelligently work for a takedown, try and get back on top.
Heifel trying to pick his range here. Nice low kick there coming out of the champ. Heifel answers back himself again. Both fighters very measured here in their exchanges. In this position, Bucha has got to start to feel some urgency.
Yeah, eventually. He knows he has this round and one more to go, but he cannot end up on his back again.
This is not where the champion wants to be. Big takedown from Heifel. Bucha has got to work off his back here. Both feet on the hips, looking for a sweep, trying to attack that arm again. Heifel work in this position.
Bucha hasn't really worked to get up from this position. He's been working a lot of submissions, but hasn't worked to get back to his feet.
And Heifel is absolutely content to stay in the guard and land punches because he's winning the fight.
100%. Smart tactic out of Heifel. Like I said, he wanted to work to a takedown. He didn't want to stay on the feet and eat too many of those rear leg round kicks out of Zach Bucha.
Bucha trying to go high. Heifel shoves him right off. Ends up in top position. Heifel is absolutely dominating the top position here. Halfway through the fourth round.
And again, it's because Bucha isn't working to get back up.
Yeah, Bucha needs to start working the submissions that we saw earlier in the fight. Again, right here, looking for the armbar. Bucha trying to lock it in.
He might have that. He got it. Bucha gets a submission victory.
Oh, my goodness.
As quick as that, Bucha gets a submission victory.
Calm, cool, and collected is Zach Bucha.
Lot of disappointment on Aaron Heifel. It only takes 1 second for Zach Bucha to finish a fight.
As we look at our Mattingly Lumber instant replay, he immediately moves into that position. Aaron Heifel, both hands trapped there.
Yeah, I believe he verbally tapped the referee, Mike Anglin. Couldn't tap with the hands.
Aaron Heifel, of course, visibly upset in that fight. But what a calm, seasoned vet is Zach Bucha.
Yeah, just as I was saying, Bucha needed to work back to his feet. He showed me wrong and got a submission victory.
What action here, ladies and gentlemen, tonight for Shamrock FC 295. Zach Bucha remains the champion. will get the offer of the four-fight deal in Bellator. What a night.
Great night of fights and a great Shamrock FC title defense out of Zach Boucher.
Huge fight. Let's send it up to the cage to Stephen Bayer for our final results.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout has ended. 3 minutes and 3 seconds of round number four. Your winner from an arm bar out of the red corner, and still Shamrock FC champion, Zach Boucher.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am here with your champion, Zach Boucher. Zach, first of all, amazing fight. He had you, I mean, really tough there on the ground. A huge fight. He was up quite a bit in that fight. How do you feel, though, after that huge submission?
Yeah, I feel good. He was up all the rounds. He was doing a really good job. He countered everything like they did their homework. Everything that I throw, they were counting, which means I got to go back to the drawing board with my coaches. I know they're going to hound me harder than ever because I gave them a heart attack. I know those 3 rounds. But it's one thing I always believed. If you're a champion, you got to find a way to win. You know, I was down on the rounds, but you got to look and you got to stay in there. You got to stay in there mentally and you got to find that way to win.
So I got to ask, you know what's on the line. What's next?
I got to talk to my coaches and my manager and Jesse Finney and Shamrock and all of them who've done so much for me, and then we'll see what's next.
But that contract to Bellator is on the table now for your champion, Zach Boucher.